so obvious to me. The thing that was also in Global was that you made some really beautiful sounds. You made some really light sounds, and when you play the passage where you vibrate it continuously, it really, really works. I would encourage you to continue thinking about vibrato, because way too many notes go by without any color. And if you're going to get really flautando and not vibrate, you should be doing some other composer. Okay. So what I'd love to talk a little bit about is just your bow. Your bow hold, your bow arm. I think part of the reason you have the bulges to the extreme is partly because your bow hold isn't, I think, sealed enough onto the bow. Okay? So I notice when you go to the frog, your first finger moves. And when you go to the tip, your pinky and sometimes even this finger move. And what that tells me is you're not really holding the bow. What you're doing is you're resting on top of the bow. And that's why we get a very unfocused sound. We get more of this kind of sound like that, because you're not really holding the bow. So what I like to think of is not that I'm holding the bow, but that my right arm is actually much longer than my left arm. It goes out about 2 feet more. Okay, it's as if you had a little drop of super glue on each contact point where the hand is, and you can't remove them. And that doesn't mean that your hand is frozen, you know. But if you've ever given your finger to a baby, they don't give it back. It's pretty incredible, you know. You can pick them up and they'll just be holding on, right? It's really kind of, don't try that. I did. My son still hates me, but anyway. But it's really, really a good image to think of. Holding the bow firmer, but having a soft hand, a soft palm. Don't squeeze with your thumb. Your thumb isn't a finger. But these four guys have to really be on there. And then when you have a better seal between the hand and the beginning of the bow, it really is just one ligament from your shoulder to the tip of your bow, okay? Let's just begin with only that image before I start kind of piling on all sorts of stuff and your ears start smoking, okay? Just try the beginning of this, maybe even without pinch, just for a second.
Okay,
pick up to 9.
Okay.
A little less. nice thing about curved bridges is that we can actually play different levels and still only touch one string. The nice thing about that, if I'm going to go from this string to that string, I don't have to go like this. I can go like this. So it makes for a much smoother change. And so the difference would be, if I'm playing the Brahms, that's kind of what you're doing. Okay, instead of moving.
Thank you. Thank you.